My name is Ashley Salvatori from mycoachashley.com, and today I'm going to talk to you about the differences between a ketogenic diet and a low-carb diet. So these two things, you've probably heard keto, keto diet, macros, micros, and low carb, and you're probably like, what the heck are these things, and what's the difference, and how do you know what to do and which one to follow? Okay, so here you go. The ketogenic diet is really when you start balancing your macros, your macronutrients, which are your fats, your proteins, and your carbohydrates. So with the ketogenic diet, you really want to focus on eating enough fat, moderate protein, and low carbohydrates. So when you do this, and you can use apps to enter in the foods that you're eating to see that you're in the balance, the macronutrient balance, to make sure that you are following it correctly, that can definitely help in the beginning. But what this does is it gets your body shifted from burning glucose as its primary fuel source to burning fat for fuel. And what happens is you get into a state of what's called ketosis. And when you are in ketosis, your body is running efficiently. You have focus, you have energy, you have clarity, you feel really good. And you're able to go long periods of time without eating, and you're able to be more satisfied with the foods that you eat. And there are tons of benefits to following the ketogenic diet, in addition to weight loss, which definitely helps when you follow that sort of meal plan. Next, let's talk about the low carb diet. So now, low carb is something where you're only looking at net carbs. I do have a video that explains more about net carbs if you want to check that out if you're not sure how to count a net carb. But basically, a net carb is when you take the total carbs and you subtract the fiber from that, and you get the net carb. And so when you're following a low carb diet, many people recommend between 20 to 50 net carbs. And so when you're following a low carb diet, that's the only thing you're concerned about. You're just concerned about your net carbs. And you can lose weight following that type of plan. And I do recommend in the beginning, as you're just getting into this, maybe you just start with a low carb diet so it's not too overwhelming, because I know a lot of people just getting started, they can look at this and be like, oh my gosh, I have no idea where to start. If you just start with counting your net carbs to begin, that can be an easy way to transition into this. And actually, if you check out my 74 pound transformation video, I'll pop the video link up here, you can see how I was following a low carb diet for the beginning stages of my transformation until I started balancing macros a little bit later on, because it's an easy transition in and it's not too overwhelming and it does get results. I was also working out during this time, so I was exercising, which helps a lot. But basically, a low carb diet, one thing that makes the difference between the two is that low carb, you can kind of be at that level where you are just teetering on being in ketosis. So what that means is you might be right there where you're either in ketosis or you're not in ketosis. You might be feeling terrible. You might be tired all the time, and you might just have low energy, and you might be groggy, moody, and you might even still be having some food cravings. And that would be because your carb threshold isn't kicking you deep into ketosis the way that you should be. Whereas if you're following the ketogenic diet and you get into ketosis and you're burning that fat for fuel and your body is running on those ketones naturally, then that's going to happen for you. Now, there are some tips that I can give you if you just want to follow a low carb diet and you don't want to go too in depth with the ketogenic diet, and still get a lot of those benefits that you get when you follow the ketogenic diet and you're deep into ketosis. One way is with exogenous ketones. I actually added this in towards the end of my full transformation because I didn't even know they existed. And if I knew they existed, oh my gosh, I would have started that from the beginning, because they have made such a difference in my low carb ketogenic lifestyle, and they allow for so much flexibility. Now, this is a personal choice. Of course, you can eat very, very strict keto and get into ketosis naturally and do that whole thing. But it's really, really hard to do that. And a lot of people find they struggle most with being able to stay in that state and stick to that strict nutritional plan for long term. And it's very easy to fall off track, and it's very difficult to get back on. So that's what leads this exogenous ketones, which basically it's a drink that you drink that gives your body the beta hydroxybutyrate, which is the ketone, so that it helps your body, your brain run on the ketones so that you're burning, even if you're following low carb and you're not nutritionally getting to that level of ketosis, you are now feeling amazing, feeling the energy, feeling the clarity, able to stick to the plan, feeling good, and moving forward towards reaching your goals. And if you fall off track, it's easy to come back on. It actually puts your body into ketosis within an hour. So that helps a lot. But again, it's a personal choice, and you can get started with just a ketogenic diet. Follow that type of meal plan, see how you do, but if you're noticing that you're feeling these effects where you're just kind of groggy, not feeling great, then it's probably you need to either start really strictly balancing your macros a little bit more so that you get into a deeper state of ketosis, or try adding in the exogenous ketones following the low-carb meal plan. See how you do with that situation. I personally follow a strict keto meal plan along with adding in the exogenous ketones, and then sometimes I will just eat a low-carb meal plan and I won't really be balancing my macros. So it's really up to you how you want to do it. If you're interested in learning more about the ketones, I'll pop a link up here so you can check them out and learn more about that. But thanks guys for checking out my channel. I post tons of videos on the ketogenic diet, low-carb, high-fat diet, so that you can learn more and get the education you need to move forward in reaching your goals with a way to literally burn fat for fuel. So be sure to hit that subscribe button on my channel. And thanks guys for watching this one. Take care.